हेलो। सर कार्तिक सर
हेलो डॉक्टर
ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಬರ್ಕಬೇಕು ಸರ್ ಈಗ
ಇಲ್ಲ ರಿವಿಷನ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋದು ಆಗಿರೋ ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಎಂಟು
ಸರ್
ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಐದು ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಮತ್ತೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಯಾವ ಥರ
ಇದು ಐದು ಮೆಥಡ್ ಐದು ಇವು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಅದು ಬರ್ದಿರಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಈಗ
ಹಾಂ ಎಲ್ಲ ಐದು ಮೆಥಡ್ ಈ ವೀಕಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದಾವ್ದು ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಬರ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಎಲ್ಲದೂ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ
ಸರ್
ರಿವಿಷನ್ ಥರ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಏನೇನು ಎಂಟು ಯಾವ ಥರ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ
ಸರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಹೆಂಗೆ ತಂಗ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ ಸರ್
ಹಾಂ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್
ಬರ್ಕಂತ
ಯಾವಾಗ
ಅಂತ ಸರ್ ಏನು ಸರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್
ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಹಳೆ ಯಾವಿದಾವ ನೋಡಿ ಹಾಕ್ತೀನಿ ನಮಗೆ ಹಾಕಿಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ
ಸರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ಸರ್ ಅವಾಗಲೇ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಏನೂ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ
ಅದು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಒಂದು ಹೇಳ್ರಿ ಸರ್
ಯಾಕೆ ಯಾರು ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಇಷ್ಟು ಜನ
ಏನ್ ಸರ್
ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಯಾರು ಇಷ್ಟು ಜನ ಇದ್ದೀರಲ್ಲ
ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಸರ್ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ತಡ್ರಿ ಸರ್
ಕಾಗಕ್ಕ ಫೋಟೋ ತಗಸಕಂತಾಳ ಹೇಳ ಸಖ್ಯ
ಏನೋ ನಿಂದು ಹೋಗ್ ನನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್
ಮತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ನನ್ಗೊಂಡಿದೆ ಬಿಡವ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಕ್ಕಿಗೆ ನೋಡಕ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಡ ಬಿಡವ
Okay, good afternoon. Today we shall revise the five methods of design. That is, we have completed all the five methods of design. That is, we are designing the flexible pavement design. We have studied about the first method, first basic method in flexible, first type of design was Mcleod method. Okay, second type of design was Khanas method. Third type of design was IRC 1970, that is old method. Fourth type of design was CBR method, and fifth and final type of design was CSA method, that is cumulative standard axial method. And for this, the reference code book is IRC 37 2001. in all the five methods, the basic step or basic objective is to find out the total thickness of the pavement with the given data. Okay, we are using all the data to find out the total thickness. We shall first study about the Mcleod method. First method is Mcleod method. Okay, can everyone see the screen? Okay, this is a Mcleod method. That is, in this Mcleod method, four types of diameter plates will be using. That is 75, 60, 40 and 45 and 30 centimeter diameter plate. These are the four types of okay. These are the four types of diameter plate, that is 75 centimeter, 60 centimeter, 45 centimeter and 30 centimeter. And for this test, that is, this test is Mcleod used plate bearing test method. And for this test, the diameter of the plate which you used is 30 centimeter. This is the diameter of the plate which you used. Using this plate, he conducted the plate bearing test and he find out the total thickness of the pavement. That is, the formula for this method is, and here deflection, that is, deflection is 0.5 centimeter. This is, deflection is 0.5 centimeter for this method. And the thickness, initially you have to find out the K value. K is equal to P divided by 0.125. This is the formula given by plate bearing test method. Okay, and next your basic step is to find out the thickness. T is equal to K log 10 P divided by S. P will be given in the question, that is load. S is the total subgrade support in kg that you need to find out. Okay, then K is the constant that you are finding out from the graph. These are the methods, these are the steps to find out the thickness of the pavement. Okay, we shall see the and these are the two curves which you are using. That is, first type of curve where perimeter area ratio versus ratio of subgrade is given, you are finding, and deflection will be given. And in the second graph, you are finding the K value. These are the two graphs which you are using. Okay. Okay, once we shall revise, that is, yes. Can everyone see this question? Is this question visible? Okay, that is, you can see, design a highway pavement for a wheel load. That is, they have given a wheel load. Wheel load means 5,443 kg, capital P value they have given, with a tire pressure. Tire pressure means small p they have given. The plate bearing test carried out on the subgrade soil using 30 centimeter diameter plate. That is, dia of the plate also given, and deflection, that is 0.5 centimeter deflection they have given. Okay, let's see how to solve. That is capital P is given. With the help of these two, you have to find out A is equal to A. You are going to find out. Then in the second step, you are finding diameter. Diameter is equal to 2 times the radius. Okay, then after that, you are finding, in the third step, you are finding perimeter by area ratio, that is equal to 2 divided by P. Finding this one. Okay, and in the next step, okay, listen here. In this question, you have got the perimeter by area ratio as 0.118. Can you see this? Perimeter by area ratio is 0.118. Yes, I am getting disturbance from some of the people. I request to mute your audio. Okay, I am muting everyone. If you have any doubts, message me. Okay, there is a message option in this app. You can message me or you can raise your hands. Okay. Okay, that is perimeter and area ratio. You need to find, you have been found out, and the graph is given. That is, go to the previous page here. That is 0.118. You can see here, right? That is x-axis versus y-axis. X-axis represents the perimeter area ratio, that is P by A. And you have worked out that you got the answer as 0.118, which is nearer to 0.112. And you can see these lines. These lines are called as deflection lines. Okay, for 0.112 deflection, they are given in the question as 0.5. Yes, 0.112 versus deflection as 0.5. And just take it to the y-axis. You will get value somewhere here, which is equal to the 0.96 or 0.95. Okay, you will get the answer as 0.96 or 0.95. This is the answer. That is, the unit supported 0.5. This is the answer, 0.96. This is the, from the curve, ratio of unit upgrade support 34 centimeter diameter plate at 0.5 centimeter deflection. This 0.5 centimeter deflection, they have been mentioned in the question. You have got the value as 0.96. Okay. Later, in the next step, you have to multiply obtained value with the given pressure. That is, this 2.5 centimeter per second is given in question. You can see here, this is the pressure. 0.96 was the obtained value. You need to multiply with this given. That is pressure, yielded pressure. 0.96 into 2.5 kg per centimeter square. Okay. 0.96 into 2.5. That is, you are getting the value as 2.4 kg per centimeter square. Later, you need to find out the S value. That is 2.4 into area. Area means either pi r square or pi d square divided by 4. You can directly multiply with the area of circle, either pi r square or pi d square by 4. 2.4 will be obtained in the previous step. 2.4 into pi into d square divided by 4, which is equal to 2130 kg. Okay. Next, refer the curve 1. This is the curve 1. Okay, 2130 kg, and you have to find out the K value. What is the bearing plate diameter? Bearing plate diameter is 34. You will get somewhere here. Okay, just take it and touch it to the graph. Okay, and it will coincide here, and just split this graph into the y-axis. You will get value somewhere here, isn't it? That is in between 90 and 100. And in the question, in the solution, they have taken the answer as 96. Okay, that is K log 10 P divided by S. From curve 1, base course constant K for 34 centimeter diameter plate is 95. Okay, then T is equal to K log 10 P by S. K value we have found out in the previous step, P value given in the question, S was found out in the earlier step, that is 2136 kg. Then directly substitute. Will get the answer as 39.7 centimeter, which is approximately equal to the 40 centimeter. Okay, and another important information in this Mcleod method is, among this 40 centimeter, provide 5 centimeter for bituminous surfacing. Is it clear? This is the basic thing. Yes, everyone understood? Hello.
34 in the
34 diameter. ನೀವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ 17 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ರೇಡಿಯಸ್ ಕಂಡಿಡ್ದಿದ್ದೀರ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಎಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರೇಡಿಯಸ್ 17 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್, ಕರೆಕ್ಟಾ? ಡಯಾಮೀಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 2 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ದ ರೇಡಿಯಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಇಸ್ 34 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್. ಡಯಾಮೀಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 34 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್
ಸರ್? ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕರ್ವ್ ಇಂದ 0.96 ಬಂದ ಸರ್.
ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕರ್ವ್ ಇಂದ 0.95,
ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕರ್ವ್ ಇಂದ 96 ಸರ್. ಸಿಮಿಲಾರಿಟೀಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಸರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಸರ್? ಅಣ್ಣ,
ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕರ್ವ್ ಇಂದ 96 ಅಲ್ಲ 95 ಬಂದಿರೋದು, ಅದನ್ನ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಿರಾ 95/100. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಕರ್ವ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಹೆಂಗಿದೆ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕರ್ವ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ? ಹೌದಾ? 0, 25, 50, 75. ಇದೆ 96 ಬಂದಿ, 95 ಏನೋ ಬಂದಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 100 ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀರಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ಒನ್ಸ್.
ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್?
Yes, first P, they will give the capital P, P, and you are finding the radius. This is the first step. Later, if you get the radius, you can convert it into diameter. That is, D is equal to 2A. You have got the perimeter by area ratio.
This sir, not audible, sir.
Okay, in the third step, that is perimeter by area ratio you have obtained. That is 2 divided by P. Okay, next, you are using the first curve. Refer the curve. Refer the curve and obtain the value.
Sir, 2 by P, sir, other?
2 by P. Obtain the value from the graph. Obtain the value from graph. Okay. Next, in the next step, you are multiplying. You are finding the S value. That is, in the fifth step, what you are doing? Multiply. Multiply this value. Multiply this value with yielded pressure. With yielded pressure. Yielded pressure will be given in the question. With yielded pressure. Okay, this value they will give in the question. Later in the sixth step, that is S is equal to above answer. Call it as A. You will get some value which you can call it as H. Okay? H into area. H into area. Area of the circle or tire. Okay, next step. After that, again you are referring the curve. Okay, refer the curve and obtain K value. And next step, find the thickness. Find T value. T is equal to K log 10 P by S. T is equal to K log 10 P divided by capital S. In that, in the next step, give 5 centimeter. Okay. Provide 5 centimeter for bituminous surface. Provide 5 centimeter for bituminous surface. Bituminous surface. Is it clear? Hello?
Sir, the value is 5 centimeters.
5 centimeters minimum could be thickness.
Sir, answer 20 least bandra could sir. Huh? The value least bandra could sir.
Minimum or 5 centimeters could have nevalle. Okay. I will explain one more problem. Ide method alli innond problem ide. Yararigu artha agilla mattond sala nodkolre. That is second problem. Okay, next problem. They have given the same data. That is, yes, design a highway pavement of wheel load 4100 kg. That is capital P value they have given. This is a capital P. With the tire, capital P is given and tire pressure. Tire pressure means small p. Small p, 5 kg per centimeter yes, square. And you have to design by Mcleod method. Plate bearing test was carried out on subgrade soil using 30 centimeter diameter plate and yielded pressure same 2.5 kg per centimeter. In the previous question also, yielded pressure was 2.5 kg per centimeter after 10 repetitions. Okay, at 0.5 centimeter deflection. Suppose if they won't give this deflection for the first type of problem, that is Mcleod method, you have to assume delta is equal to 0.5 centimeter. Clear? First step. What is the first step? You have to find out the radius of contact, that is A. That is, your formula is small p is equal to capital P divided by area. If you sort out, the equation will become A is equal to load divided by pi into tire pressure. Load value they have given, that is 4100 kg. Pi into tire pressure they have given. You will get the radius as 16.2 centimeter. Multiply this with 2. You will get diameter as 32.4 centimeter. Next step is to find out the perimeter and area ratio. Perimeter of circle is 2 pi r divided by area of circle is pi into r square. And if you cancel 2 pi and pi and r and r, you will get the final equation as 2 divided by r. 2 into r. R means radius you have obtained here. That is 16.2 centimeter. you will get perimeter and area ratio as 0.123. Move to the graph 1. Okay, you have to refer the graph 1. That is, this is the graph 1. You have obtained the value of a perimeter by area ratio as point. How much is the perimeter by area ratio? In the previous problem, it is 0.123. You will get the value somewhere here, 0.123. And deflection is 0.5. Just drag this to the 0.5 and take it to the y-axis. You will get the answer somewhere near 0.969798. Okay. 0.9697. Okay, here also you can next you have to find out the K value and obtain diameter is 32.4 centimeter. Just the same answer, 96 to 98 will get. You are substituting the same answer in the problem. Okay. Point nine six into 2.5 is the yielded pressure. You will get the answer. Later you have to find out the S. S is equal to this 2.4 into area. Area is pi d square divided by 4. That is subgrade support. You will get it as 1979 kg. And from the curve 1, you have got the diameter as 90 centimeter or 0.9. P is equal to 0.9 into log 10. P they are given in the question. S you have find out in the earlier step, that is 1979 kg. Thickness you will get it as 29 centimeter. Among this 29 centimeter, provide 5 centimeter.
5 centimeter per
thick. This bituminous surface. Clear? This yes, is sir. The first type of problem. Everyone got clear? Shall we move for the second type?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is it clear for everyone? Okay. Next, second type of design is Khanas method. Okay. Or they in the question they can give it as Khanas triaxial method. And for this you have to find out the thickness. This is the initial formula. Delta is equal to 3pa² divided by 2e a² plus z² into the power of 1/2. But in the question, along with these data, they will give the modulus of subgrade reactions for different layers. That is, for surface course they may give, or base course they may give, or subgrade. They will give the modulus of subgrade reaction separately. So you have to multiply. And another. Okay. This is the formula, that is thickness. TS is equal to 3P divided by 2pi ES delta whole square minus A square. This is the formula. And along with that, they will give the modulus of subgrade reaction. So your equation will become. Yes, this is the final equation, that is T is equal to 3P into X into Y divided by 2pi delta ES whole square minus A square into ES divided by EB. Okay, and this is inversely proportional to the thickness, that is they have provided here thickness. I will show the relation. Okay, that is thickness. Thickness is indirectly proportional to the modulus of subgrade reaction. TB is inversely proportional to EB and TC is inversely proportional to EC to the power of 1 divided by 3. This is the formula. Okay, you are just substituting that through here. And the final equation is
break acted, sir.
Okay. Okay, find out the thickness. Thickness is equal, the formula for thickness is provided by. The formula is given by T is equal to 3P XY divided by 2pi delta ES whole square minus a square into es divided by eb. All the values will be given. P means load value, capital P. X means traffic coefficient. Traffic coefficient value will be given. Capital Y means rainfall coefficient or saturation coefficient. This will be given. A means radius. We will be finding out, that is small p divided by capital P. Yes, modulus of elasticity for subgrade. They will be given question. Then EB, that is modulus of elasticity of base course or pavement layer. This will be given in the question. Okay. Okay. Now this is the question. That is, design the pavement section by triaxial test method. Triaxial method or Khanas method, one and only same. Triaxial test method using the following data. Wheel load that they have given. Capital P is equal to 4100 kg. Then radius of contact area, that is small a, is given, which is 15 cm. No need to find out the area, that is radius. In the previous problem you are finding out the radius. Here they have directly provided the radius. Then third one, rainfall traffic coefficient, which means x, they have provided in the question. Next, rainfall coefficient y value is equal to 0.9, they have given. Then design deflection delta is equal to 0.25 cm. The difference between this method and previous method is, in previous method, that is in Mcleod method, delta value is equal to 0.5 cm. If they won't give in the question, you have to assume delta is equal to 0.5 cm in previous method, that is Mcleod method. In this method, that is in Khanas method, if they won't give the delta value, you have to assume delta value as 0.25 cm. ES value they have given, that is modulus of subgrade reaction, 100 kg per centimeter square. EB they have given, 400 kg per centimeter square. Then E value of 7.5 cm thick bituminous concrete surface. In previous problem, what you are doing, you are providing minimum of 5 cm thick for a top layer, that is bituminous concrete layer. Here you have to provide 7.5 cm thick, they will give in the question. Okay, if they won't provide in the question, you have to assume and you have to take this value as 7.5 cm. Clear? And E value of this bituminous concrete surface is 1000 kg per centimeter square. Don't get confused. EB means one type of EB is base course. This is bituminous concrete surface. You can provide either with E small b or E to the base c. Okay, don't get confused, because both the letter, initial letter will be B only. This capital B refers to the modulus of base course. Okay, here they have provided next value is 1000 kg per centimeter is the modulus of elasticity of the bituminous concrete surface. Clear? Okay, here direct substitution, that is thickness. Thickness formula is 3PXY divided by 2π delta ES square minus A square to the power of ES by EB to the power of 1/3. Okay, P value they have given. What is the P value? 4100 kg. Then
4100 kg.
Yes. X value is 1.5. Y value is 0.9.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Divided by 2 into pi into delta. Delta means deflection. Deflection value they have given here. That is 0.25 cm is the deflection. Then ES means modulus of elasticity of subgrade reaction. They have given, that is 100 kg per centimeter square into ES by EB to the power of 1/3. The direct substitution, 3 into P value is 4100, X is 1.5, Y is 0.9, 2 divided by 2 into pi, delta value is 0.25, and ES value is 100 kg per centimeter square. This is the radius value they have given, into and ES divided by EB to the power of 1/3. You will get the thickness value. Direct substitution, nothing is complicated in this step. Okay, you have to directly substitute the thickness value, which is equal to 66 cm. You have got the value as 66 cm. Everyone got clear this step? All the values will be given. You have to just note down. Clear? Is it clear? Okay. Next step. In the next step, what you have to do, you have found out the total thickness. Okay. That is the entire thickness of the pavement you have been found out. Now you have to assign individual thickness. That is thickness for surface course, thickness for base course, and thickness for subgrade course. You have to provide this. So you are using the another formula. That is, I told the thickness is inversely proportional to the subgrade reaction to the power of 1/3. Right, this is the formula, that is TB divided by TP. TB is inversely proportional to EB. TP is inversely proportional to EP to the power of 1/3. Okay, bituminous concrete surface you have to assume as 7.5. Here they have given in the question, that is EB, E value of 7.5 centimeter thick bituminous concrete. That is thickness of bituminous concrete surface is given. Also, elastic value of bituminous concrete surface is given. Indirectly, you can find out the thickness of these two layers, right? Two unknowns. This is given, and DB is given. Only you need to find out TEB and TS. Use this formula. That is TB by TP is equal to EP divided by EP to the power of 1/3. TB, this is the pavement or bituminous concrete surface, 7.5. And elastic modulus of bituminous concrete surface is 1000. And elastic modulus of which on base course layer is 400. You will get the answer as TB answer as 10.2 centimeter. Okay. The total thickness pavement was 66 centimeter. Deduct 66 from this. 66 minus 10.2 centimeter. You will get the answer as 66 minus 10.2 is equal to 55.8 centimeter. You have found out two thicknesses. That is, one is thickness of the bituminous concrete surface you have found out. Now, the second step, you have found out the thickness of the base course. Which is the another layer? You have to find out the thickness of the subgrade. TS you have to find out. Same formula. Okay. Now, that is 66 minus 10.2 is equal to 55.8 centimeter. Just draw the figure. 7.5 centimeter is the thickness of the bituminous concrete and 55.8 is the base course layer. Suppose if they ask to find out the subgrade layer, just take here instead of TB, substitute TS, and here substitute the value of subgrade reaction so that you can find the values of each layer. Is it clear? Hello?
Yeah.
Is it clear for everyone?
Yeah.
Okay. Same type of problem. We shall solve another problem. See here, they are given ES value, that is modulus of elasticity of subgrade. Then modulus of elasticity of bituminous concrete or pavement, you can tell. Then wheel load, that is capital P, they are given. Tire pressure means small p. Here they have not given radius here. So you have to find out the radius. That is small p is equal to capital P divided by area. With the help of that, you are finding the radius. Then traffic coefficient X is given. Saturation coefficient Y is given. And design thickness of pavement layer, base course and sub-base course are to be provided. E values, that is E values of pavement layer is 400 and E values of base sub-base course is 200 kg per centimeter square. Here they have not provided delta. You have to assume it as 0.25 centimeter. Substitute all the value. Delta TB is equal to 3P XY divided by 2 pi E delta E square minus A square. 3. P means 5100. X value they have given 1.25. Y value they have given in the question 0.8 divided by 2 into pi delta value 0.5 ES. That is modulus of elasticity of subgrade reaction. That is 90 kg per centimeter square they are given. 90 minus TS. A means capital P P by pi r square. Okay. Into ES divided by EB. 90 divided by 400 to the power of 1/3. Thickness you have got as 65.2 centimeter. That is total thickness of the pavement. Next, you have to find the individual thickness. That is TB divided by TP is equal to EP divided by EB. TP, that is thickness of the bituminous concrete surface, you have to assume as 7.5 centimeter. TB you can find out with the help of these two. That is, you got the TB value as 9.83 centimeter. Deduct from the total thickness, 65.17 minus 9.83. We'll get it as 55.37 centimeter. Similarly, find out the subgrade thickness of the subgrade reaction. TB, you have calculated TB value is 55.37 centimeter. We have found out here. And TS value, you have been given ES and EB value. Thickness of the subgrade you will be getting. Clear?
Sir, next problem, sir. Next problem.
Okay. Shall we move for the next type of design?
Yeah.
Okay. Join with the same ID and password. Only 4 minutes is remaining. I will end the session and I will join with the same ID and password. Okay. Join with the same ID and password.